Good afternoon, everybody, and happy, it's actually Saturday, even though I'm going to post this, it's actually Friday, I'm going to post this Saturday. So, I did a video today, and it was worse than some of my other videos, I have to be honest, but it kind of wasn't my fault. I went to a place very early today called Bagliani's, which is an Italian market where I live, to get something called baccala, which is salted cod, which I'm going to make later this week. And I needed to go get it set up because I'm going to do a little video on how to handle it, how to make it. So let's talk about that first. Baccala is part of a feast known as the Feast of the Seven Fishes. Now, apparently this started in Italy because you would fast all day and you wouldn't eat meat on high holy days, so you would eat fish. And then it, you know, made its way to the U.S. with Sicilian immigrants, which is where my family picked it up. So we used to do this all the time, and then we stopped. You know, honestly, it's kind of a tradition, I think, for a lot of Italian families. In our case, it's dying because the older members of our family are dying out, and all of a sudden, us kids are the adults, which is totally weird. You know, it's like one day you're sitting at the folding kids table and the next thing you know, your kids are at the folding kids table and you're the adult now. And it's weird. It's really, really weird. Or worse, your kids' kids are at the folding kids table. Anyway, the tradition's kind of dying, but my sister and I were toying with doing the idea this year. So I said, well, you know, I'll do the baccala because it's one of those things that's like, nobody knows how to cook this anymore because it is a giant piece of cod. It's like a half a cod, no head, no tail. They fillet it and then they salt it. And when I say salt it, I'm not kidding. This thing is so salty. So right now, today's the first day, I have it soaking in just water, which I will change later, and I'm going to actually use milk. Now, the reason that the milk works to get the salt out of the fish is kind of a really interesting and really scientific and kind of simple thing. If you've ever had a cramp in your leg, like they will tell you like it's lactic acid and that's why you're getting like the cramping, which is why these drinks like Gatorade are full of salt, because these two react with each other. So by using milk to get the to soak the fish, I pull the saltiness out because these two have a reaction. So that lactic acid in the milk is going to pull all the salt out of this fish. And then I'm going to cook it in a pretty heavy tomato sauce, and there's going to be potatoes in there. Potatoes and tomatoes are both very high in potassium. So then again, there's another reaction because you have salt and potassium, which kind of do this dance. Actually, in your body, that dance is what keeps your heart pumping. So that's what I'm going to be doing, and I will be showing you guys the recipe. It's kind of a nice, really nice stew. It's real hearty. I am the only one in my family that eats baccala. I might be able to tempt one of my nephews to eat it this year. I think they've tried it before. I think my sister ate it one year. If I cook it with the tomato, she seems to like it, but I'm kind of the only one that eats it. But I'll show you guys how I'm going to cook it. And that will be my Wednesday video, because that's going to be Christmas Eve. Christmas, is that Wednesday? Christmas Eve? I think it's Christmas Eve. Anyway, so basically, I went to Bagliani's to do this video for you guys of this really awesome place that hasn't probably changed in 40, 60 years, right? It's a small family-owned Italian market. They make their own sausage. I know that freaks out the vegetarians, but the thing about that is the quality of the sausage is much better. They have an incredible selection of imported olive oils, domestic olive oils. They have cheese, olives. It is the only place locally that I can get Sicilian olives. Sicilian olives are a small black olive, and they're cured in oil. And it sounds gross, but they're super salty, oily little things, and they are so fucking good. They're so fucking good. In fact, the best pizza I've ever had in my life was made by this guy from Italy, and I didn't want to eat it. It had Sicilian black olives on it and anchovies, which I always hated anchovies until he made anchovies for me. Not only did he make fresh anchovies one day, and they were unbelievable because you bread them and fry them, and they're so good when they're fresh. But when he put the anchovies on that pizza, I got it. I understand why anchovies on pizza is a thing. That sweet from the sauce and then the super salty from that fish is incredible. And for people that are vegan, you can do the same thing with these Sicilian olives. They're oily and salty, and they're so good. But anyway, I digress. I did a lot of shopping. In fact, in the video, you'll notice that like I keep showing my cart. The reason is when I went in, I asked them if I could film, and they said, sure, that's fine. Just please don't film any people. Don't interfere with people shopping. I was like, fine. No problem. Literally every time I went to, well, first of all, let me tell you, I went there at like 8 a.m. thinking I'm going to beat the crowd so I can film. Every little old lady who lives in Hamilton was in that place. When I first walked in, it was me, and there was one guy wandering around and one person checking out. As soon as I took the camera out to film, it was like a tour bus showed up and released everybody into the building. But so every time I would go to like film something, somebody would like walk up and either be trying to shop, or they'd look at me, which is like, so I kept like retaking. So I did get my kind of standard Italian American Christmas stuff, which was, I got my traditional pizzelles. If you don't know what a pizzelle is, it is an incredibly thin cookie. And they come in different flavors, but I get the anisette, which is the kind of licorice-y flavor. It's the really traditional one. And the best way I can describe them is they kind of look like a snowflake or like a spider web. And they're round and they're about this big. And they're so super delicious. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'll take a picture of the pizzelle and I'll take a picture of the panettone. Panettone is this bread. But it's a bread that has fruit in it. It is probably the much better tasting version of fruitcake, or where fruitcake really started. Because it's really like one of those, if you've ever had a bread that's kind of on the sweet side, it's like that. And then in it, it's got all these amazing raisins and sultanas are like raisins, but they're like a golden color and they're much smaller. And I got one of those. And what I do with that, which I might also do a video for you guys because it's like really easy and I could shoot the video the night before, but I make a baked French toast using panettone. And it's so good. And the great thing about it is I'll be able to take it to my nephew's house, which is where we're having Christmas Eve night, and just put it in the fridge. And then I'll go over there early, I'll pop it in the oven. And while it's in the oven, the kids can open their gifts, people can open their gifts, we can make some coffee, and then I'll probably just, I don't know, maybe make some eggs or something, and we'll have the panettone, the French toast style, for like our Christmas Day breakfast. So these are like some very classic things. And then I also got, there's this bread, it's an egg bread, and it's sesame seed, and it's a braided bread with sesame seeds on it, and it's an egg bread, and it is unbelievable. And I brought that home and I took the little, it's like the size of a sub roll. And I took that and I put some leftover tuna salad that I had on it. And it was seriously like, so it's so good. And if that gets stale, I will also just use that. I'll make that into French toast at my house, but it's absolutely delicious. But I will go over the recipe for the baked French toast and I will put that up Christmas Day. And I will go over the recipe Christmas Eve for the bakala. And in the meantime, I will show you how I do the bakala when I'm doing the recipe. I'll show you what it looks like when it's soaking. I think on the video that I made, which is going to be like a bonus track to this video, I think I did take a picture of the bakala because it doesn't look like anything. It's like, look, a big bag of white crumbly stuff. And then when you get it home and open it and you really realize it's like a fish fillet and there's always like a bunch of salt stuck inside the bag and stuff like that. So it's an interesting kind of thing. But until then, I would just say to you, if you like the video, subscribe, comment. I'll do some more sewing type videos soon. It's just, you know, it's Christmas time. So I'm sewing, I'm cooking, I'm sewing, I'm cooking, I'm doing all this stuff. So yeah. We'll get back to that because if you look, I don't know if you guys can see that. This is my fabric stash, and I have ordered a pattern online. I'm going to be making a skirt out of this beautiful blend. I'm going to make myself just a casual kind of big flared skirt with pockets. This is like a wool blend, so it's going to be super warm for the winter. And then everything else, I don't know what I'm going to do, but we'll talk about that later. So anyway, if you like this video, subscribe, like it, please comment. I love comments and I don't really get enough of them. And until then, I'm going to say Buon Natale and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.